Are you needing to use the same Android devices with workers so they can perform their job? How do you make sure that every worker is enabled with just the right tools to keep them focused and productive in their respective roles? Did you know that sharing devices can save you significant amounts of money while keeping your mobile operations nimble and efficient? Shared devices is a feature in SOTI MobiControl that can provide a solution to problems such as these. Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm a marketeer here at SOTI. I'd like to show you how you can set up your shared Android devices using SOTI MobiControl to empower your remote workforce, increase the return on investment of your mobile device fleet, and improve your business critical operations. Let's dive right in. First, it's important to note that the shared device feature is supported on Android, iOS, and a number of other platforms with device agent version 13.7.0 or later. To get started with sharing your Android devices, you will need to make sure your Active Directory is pre-configured by your administrator. This will be executed through your LDAP, Azure AD, or IDP connections. Please note, shared devices are based on a user that belongs to a group who needs to log into the device, so it's vital that you pre-configure the Active Directory before moving on to any further steps in the process. Once confirmed, it's time to move forward with the main process of setting up a shared device in your organization. You will need to create your device groups. If you haven't already done this, or don't know how to, you should check out our video entitled, How to Manage Device Groups. You can follow the steps in this video to organize your device groups to capitalize on shared device functionality. At this point, you can apply any rules, settings, or configurations that you would like to be enabled on the main device group or its nested device groups. Now, it's time to start configuring. For the purposes of this video, we will be setting up the device that is being shared between the warehouse manager and the warehouse associate, as they will be using the same device but will require a different set of tools as well as levels of access. On the left-hand side of the screen, in the devices view, select the desired device group that you would like to enforce a login on. This will allow you to see the More button, a green circle with three dots on the right-hand side of the device group name. Clicking on the More button will bring up the information menu. Click on Advanced Configurations. In the Advanced Configurations menu, select Android Plus from the device type drop-down list and click on the Shared Device Configuration. This will bring up the Shared Device Configuration pop-up box. The Shared Device Configuration allows you to select which user groups are authorized to log in on the device. Let's quickly run through this page to understand what all these functions do. At the top here, we see Apply Changes to All Child Groups and Devices. Select this toggle on or off to cascade the settings specified here to all nested devices and device groups. Next, we see the toggle option for Enable Shared Device Configuration. We'll touch base on this a little further in our scenario. Further down the page, we see three more toggle options. First is the toggle option for Relocate device back to the home device group on logout. Enable this option to send the device back to its original group once the device user logs out. Settings and configurations specific to the destination group will be removed, and instead, the settings and configurations of the home group will reapply. Secondly, we see the toggle option for Clear Manage Application Data when user logs out. Enable this option to delete all data from applications installed by SOTI MobiControl when a device user logs out of shared device mode. Please note that email account data is always cleared regardless of whether this option is selected or not. Finally, you have the toggle option for Disable Device Passcode when user logs out. Enable this option to clear the passcode from the device once the device user logs out. Please note that this option is only supported on iOS devices or Samsung devices running Android version 7.0 or later. Now that you have got a breakdown of what each function on this page does, let's move forward with our scenario. To continue configuring your shared device, select the Enable Shared Device Configuration toggle option and begin assigning the different user groups that will be sharing this device. To assign the user group, click on the green circle button with the plus sign. The set of available tools, apps, and access levels will be automatically applied according to their login credentials. After assigning the desired user group to the device, the next step is assigning specific users from that user group, as in our case scenario, the warehouse manager and associate. When a manager logs in, we are relocating the device to the manager device group, and likewise, when an associate logs in, we are relocating the device to the associate device group. Make sure to enable the toggle option for relocate device back to the home device group on logout. This will ensure your settings reset between each use and will also reset the user back to the login page. Finally, once you have configured your shared device settings and are happy with your new setup, just click the Save button to save your settings and apply them to your devices. It's as easy as that. Shared devices is now enabled on the specified device group. Please note, only devices assigned to this group will have shared device configuration. Now, we need to deploy a lockdown profile. You will need to create and deploy the lockdown in order to assign your user group to the shared device. To create your profile, begin by entering your profile name. Next, navigate to the Configurations tab where you will click on the green plus button in order to open up the Add Configuration pop-up menu. Select Lockdown and select the green plus button under the Custom Home Screen section. Here, you will designate a display name and then add a script tag for shared devices on lockdown. The same tags for shared devices on lockdown is the script that we have provided in this video. You can choose to use a custom image at this point if you wish. Next, select the option Launch Automatically on Startup to make sure your lockdown settings are automatically applied to your shared device group upon logging in with their credentials. To complete this part of the setup, click OK and then Save to apply your configurations. Now, it is important to note that the admin must set up an authentication password to enable the lockdown profile. To do this, click the green plus button under the Configurations tab again, and this time, select Authentication in the pop-up menu. Once in the Authentication pop-up menu, you can select your desired password for the administrator. Finally, click Save, and you are now ready to save and assign to the desired shared device group folder. Now, let's see this in action. We initiate the remote control session with the shared device that we just configured and log in as a warehouse associate. We immediately see that this device is in associate mode and that they only have access to specific applications and features that are designated for that specific device group. Once they log out, the device is ready to be used by a different user and has been relocated to the associate device group. When you log out, the device is moved back to the original folder as we specified, and it only has a MobiControl login app in single app mode. Now, let's log in as the warehouse manager on the same device. As you can see, the device is automatically configured according to the manager device group setting and ready to be used without any additional setup from the user. And there you have it. In just a few minutes, I've shown you how SOTI MobiControl makes managing your mobile devices easier than ever before using shared devices. If you find our content valuable, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you can get the latest updates. To learn more about how the SOTI One platform reduces the cost, complexity, and downtime of your business-critical mobile and IoT operations, visit www.soti.net.